Inside the ECB's Governing Council, we are all very happy that we can continue to work together with an estimated and esteemed colleague, and I want to congratulate Ignazio Visco for his reappointment as Governor of Banca d'Italia. Let me also thank Banca d'Italia for hosting this event, which is the most important event in payment systems, bringing together people from the regulatory side, oversight, from academia, but also practitioners, not only from the supply side, but also from the demand side. And that is the reason because we have not only this payment conference, but it was preceded yesterday by meetings of the European Retail Payments Board, which is a stakeholder gathering of European organizations on the supply and demand side, consumer defenders, banks, payment service providers, third-party payments providers, ACIs, and we discussed in a very constructive way the way forward, and mainly on instant payments, but also on payment initiation services, which is a very difficult topic, and we were able to make progress in that respect as well, together with the Commission, let me mention this. Then we had, back-to-back to that meeting, also a new kind of meeting to increase the ownership of our innovative approach in payment systems in Europe. And that is the European Forum for Innovative Payments, which brings together all the national payments councils that have been established and to some extent have been the follow-up of the national SEPA councils. And we had a very interactive exchange of what is being done at the European level and what are the expectations at the national level. And once again, if I would have to focus on one issue, it is that throughout all European countries, there is a conviction that instant payments has enormous potential and that we are pursuing the implementation of instant payments throughout Europe, and that has the support of the public side and is also responding to the requests of the private market people. So I think that has been extremely efficient, and that's why I'm particularly glad that today we have the occasion to exchange also with practitioners, with people representing the industry, as well as with academia. Because efficient and safe retail payments are a precondition for a functioning market economy. They allow for everyday transactions to take place, thus providing the foundation for commerce and for trade. Central banks, through cash on the one side and private banks or commercial banks, have traditionally offered these services. And they work successful to create a secure and trusted ecosystem for consumers. And this ecosystem has been quite resilient throughout the crisis. However, over time, we have to admit that the banking ecosystem has developed some inefficiencies, let's put it that way. It has lost some ability to catch up with innovation and to adapt to the changing needs of the end user, and above all to the changing requirements of the end user, especially if I look at the younger generation. In Europe, technological disruptions, competition from non-banks and regulatory pressure altogether have forced banks to re-examine how they provide retail payment services. The ability to provide real-time services will be essential for banks if they want to retain or even to gain customers. The strategic importance of instant payments in this respect cannot be overstated. The move towards a real-time world with the provision of real-time services cannot happen without pan-European instant payments. They will provide a new framework for innovative and efficient retail payments in Europe. Today, in a few words, I will focus on instant payments, but I will also briefly discuss the alleged innovation. Let's make the distinction between real innovation and fake innovation, which are brought by private virtual currency schemes without an identifiable issuer. The foundations of instant payments and ensuring stakeholder involvement are based on the Single Euro Payments Area, SEPA, which was the origin of today's digital landscape for retail payments in Europe. It is a key ingredient still today of our single currency area and was necessary to bring the full benefits of the euro closer to all citizens. This integration of electronic retail payments in Europe was full of challenges and was only completed 12 years ago, after, or 12 years after the introduction of the first coins and notes. One of the most prominent issues that faced SEPA was a lack of full stakeholder involvement. Because initially, SEPA was considered as a pure so-called IT project to be implemented by banks, and it was not seen in the overall context of a project that would have the potential to transform payments landscape in Europe. And let's not forget, as Governor Visco has just mentioned, that payments is about, above all, about money, and money is about trust and confidence. Therefore, support from all stakeholders is so crucial to the success of any undertaking in the payments area. And that is the reason why we established this ERPB, the Euro Retail Payments Board, with its composition on the supply and the demand side, including the banks, the end users, in order to further the development of a truly integrated, innovative, friendly, and competitive market for euro retail payments throughout the European Union. And this goes beyond even the euro area. This cooperation has led to new synergies. It gave a voice to those who felt also excluded from the process of innovation in retail payment systems. And we are also continuing this at this level to pursue the examination of having a more inclusive payment systems that would avoid of leaving the most vulnerable parts of our population out of innovative developments. As I said, we have also, for the same purpose of broadening the ownership of our progress in Europe, established this link between the European level and the national level through the European Forum for Innovation in Payments. The ERPB in itself was instrumental in bringing the vision of real-time payments to Europe with the inception of instant payments. The European Payments Council, which brings together mostly the supply side, acting on guidance from the ERPB, created the SEPA Credit Transfer Instant Scheme. And what was initially considered as a pure scheme might still unleash its potential for having further developments and even might be morphing into some kinds of instruments in the future. At least it lays down the ground for progress in this direction. I am pleased that this credit transfer instant scheme was successfully launched last week. And let me congratulate those 8, 9 countries which were there from the start, including Italy, and also those countries which have already yesterday announced that they will follow up very soon in the next couple of months, and I counted 5 or 6 more countries in this respect. And even the countries who were not yet able to commit mentioned that they are intent to accelerate the pace. So this creates a dynamic at the European continent-wide level to move forward in one direction. Now, European end users whose banks have already joined and implemented the scheme can send and receive instant payments across Europe in less than 10 seconds. A positive end user experience will ultimately determine the success of instant payments. At the ERPB and also at the national level, we are fully supporting the work of the industry and also the other stakeholders to facilitate the initiation of an instant payment using the recipient's mobile phone number as a proxy for their IBAN, and I think that's very important in order to make it citizen-friendly, bring it closer to the citizen. And to use your telephone number as a proxy for your IBAN, no matter where you are located in the EU. The ERPB has yesterday reconfirmed that they expect a pan-European mobile proxy lookup service to be ready by the end of 2018, at the latest. And I urge all stakeholders to ensure that this deadline is fully met. And this deadline will again coincide with the attempt by the ECB to ensure full reachability for those who have no access to an automated clearinghouse, that they could still be reachable throughout Europe, and we will ensure that inside the ECB by developing the so-called target instant payment settlement services, acronym TIPS. TIPS is scheduled to go live also in November 18. So by a year from now, we are hopeful to have the whole infrastructure in place for Europe to have a new landscape on which to build also innovation and thinking in a truly European way. SEPA and instant payments did not happen in isolation. An appropriate legislative framework that supports digitization, innovation and competition was also needed. In Europe, we realized the importance of having legal certainty. The revised payment service directive might not satisfy everyone from the outset, but we have it, and we have to live by it. But it will provide, especially the necessary legislative framework legislation, which will allow for certainty for innovation. It will enhance payment account access for regulated and authorized third-party providers, so opening up competition. It will facilitate the participation of new actors in the payments market, and these actors are the drivers to some extent for new innovative services, are the drivers to reduce costs and give consumers more choice, thereby ultimately bringing consumers closer to the European single market and make it concrete. However, this can only happen if standardized access to the payment account is provided. I would therefore call upon all stakeholders, such as banks, standard-setting organizations, as well as third-party providers, to work together to ensure a single standard is developed for payment account access. And time is of the essence in this respect, and that is the reason why we decided yesterday inside the ERPB to have a common agreement on how we would progress in the next couple of months in order to accelerate this in setting up a cooperative working group that should make progress in this respect in short term, within the next three quarters. The competition introduced by the revised Payment Services Directive can also provide an opportunity for incumbents, but only if they act urgently to implement instant payments. It is crucial that banks invest to upgrade their legacy batch systems to enable real-time processing and offer end users solutions for instant payments. These solutions can provide them with a strong tool to face the upcoming competition. The recent experience with contactless payments shows that banks, in cooperation with other stakeholders, are well capable to roll out payments innovation that quickly take off and improve end users' payments experience. But I truly believe that banks should also be as active to promote true European-based systems. It is my view that future innovations in retail payments will be based mostly on instant payments in combination with account access provided by the PSD2. I would like to stress this point especially in view of the ongoing public debate about the alleged innovation brought by private virtual currency schemes or tokens. While we have seen a substantial increase in the volume, but this increase started from a very low level, and they are widely changing the estimations of what is going on in this world, vary between 200 to 300 billion. So compared to the stock of money or to base money, it is not something that is very high. But overall, it has not been used very much for transaction purposes. Their usage as settlement asset is marginal, and the overall user acceptance as a means of payment so far can only be called negligible as well, except maybe in some failed states, of which I don't know anyone in Europe. In fact, retail payment traffic in Europe alone is orders of magnitude higher than the global transaction volume that I mentioned for virtual currencies. In view of the speculative market environment for these assets or things, and for other types of virtual financial assets, one should bear in mind that these are by definition virtual. They do not constitute a claim on an issuer and do not formally, therefore, qualify as a currency. Their purchasing power fluctuates wildly and depends solely on the market activity of people driven by speculative greed. It remains to be seen whether these virtual currencies can be considered as a payment alternative for consumers, except, as I said, in extreme cases where state services completely fail. And it remains to be seen to what extent they can compete with the solutions that market players will be able to develop together with the public authorities for a safer and more efficient European retail payments market. The ECB continues to monitor these developments, obviously, not only from a market infrastructure perspective, but also as regards monetary policy in our research, from the point of view of financial stability, and also from the point of view of prudential supervision. And while we continue to fully meet the increasing demand for safe and efficient central bank liabilities in forms of coins and banknotes. We shall also experiment with cash, which are based on different technological and digital platforms. Other advanced application of digital currency of a more disruptive nature today are simply not robust enough, both from a, not only both, but from a multiple point of view, from the legal point of view, from the operational point of view, from a governance point of view, to name but a few shortcomings which make some of these technologies unfit for recognition. I underline this, unfit for recognition from the point of view of our mandate of efficient payment systems. Let me conclude. The benefits of digital transformation and innovation for citizens can only be achieved by means of full stakeholder cooperation and appropriate regulatory framework that is fostering innovation. Banks need to implement instant payments as soon as possible and provide an alternative narrative to the ongoing public debate on the alleged innovation brought by virtual currency schemes. Instant payments in conjunction with building blocks provided by the PSD2 can offer new business opportunities for banks as well as for third-party providers, and thereby ultimately provide citizens with a real-time, safe payment experience. Thank you for your attention.